In the last video that we shot, we went over the external structures. So now I'm going to open the heart up and we're going to go over the internal structures. Okay, starting with the fossa ovalis. This is this structure right here, number 54. Okay, then you have right here, number 53, which is the coronary sinus opening. As mentioned in the previous video, we talked about the coronary sinus. This is where it empties into the right atrium. All right, here, right here, looks like carne asada, I think. But this is called the trabeculae carneae. Okay, here, these little strings right here are called the chordae tendineae. Means basically heart strings. So this muscle that sticks up right here and also over here, these are called the papillary muscles. And this section right here of the heart is called an interventricular septum. All right, now we're going to talk about the surrounding structures of the heart. And the first one we're going to talk about is the esophagus. So let me rotate it around. Okay. The esophagus sits behind the trachea. This is the trachea, but the esophagus is a flat membrane that sits behind. Yes, we think it's a round opening, but it is actually flat and it opens as we swallow. Okay, this is the trachea right here. This structure right here is the trachea. And then you have the right and left bronchus. Now, on this heart, turn it back anterior, the diaphragm sits at the base, right here, at the base, which is called the apex of this heart. It's the apex. So it sits here, all right? Now the fibrous pericardium, what that is this heart sits in a sac called a pericardial sac, all right? That sac is made up of different layers. The first layer is the fibrous pericardial sac, where it actually attaches itself to the diaphragm and the wall. Now in between that layer is called the serous pericardial sac, which it sits inside the sac. If we were to cut the pericardial sac open, it's very thin. Now which sits in that is the fluid, which is the pericardial fluid that surrounds that, which then houses the heart, which is the visceral pericardium that's actually sits on the heart, the membrane that sits actually on the heart. Now, if you went through 101, you would know the right lung sits on this side of the heart and it has three lobes. Now, on this side is the left lung, on this side, and it has two lobes. And the reason for that is to house the heart.